Hello guys, welcome to DIY. Why? Because I love it.
What's up guys, welcome to my show Mad Stuff with Rob. I am Rob and today I have a very special guest in the studio, Shadow. And if you guys follow me on Instagram, then you'll know who Shadow is. And if you don't, then pause the video, here's the ID, quickly start following me. Great, moving on. So we have Shadow in the house. He's my companion, he's my furry little friend. Actually, he's not little anymore, he's become quite big. So I decided to make something special for him because we are celebrating Mutts Day. So I'm making a brand new collar for Shadow. Shadow, are you ready? Okay then, get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. Okay, to make this dog collar, you need to grab a few items. Here's your list. So once your materials are in place, you need to pick a furry friend. Your dog, your pet. Like I have picked up Shadow here, who is my best friend, you can see. He's all good looking and handsome. He's become quite big now. So it's very important to take the right measurements of his neck. So let's take this measuring tape and measure his neck size. So I'll take about 20 inches. All right. Thank you, Shadow. And now back to the table. Okay. So here I have 20 inches, which is Shadow's neck size, and then you need to take this clip or a buckle and measure that too. So you can see the size of my clip is roughly 2 inches. So I'm left with 18 inches of neck size. That's the size you need to work with. And you have to do some simple math. You have to multiply 18 into 2, which is 36. So you need 36 feet of paracord. So we'll take the clip, we'll open it, and then switch the ends and place them on either side of this 20 inch measurement we have taken. Now we need to lock these ends and then start weaving the paracord to make the collar. Make sure it's nice and tight. It should not move. We have both the ends right here. Okay, with the clips secured, we'll get the paracord in. Now we'll take the two ends and we will find the middle of the paracord. So now we'll take our ends, put the loop right through the clip like this, fix it back, and then take the two ends, pass it through, and then just pull it. Make sure it's nice and tight. There you go. Now we'll take the two ends and we come to the bottom clip. Once you have passed both the ends from this side, we'll take the ends and move back to the clip on top. Okay, so first the left side, we will pass through the left side of this clip. And now for the right end, this will put on the right side. So now you can see we have 4 pieces here, 2 in the middle and 2 on the side. So the left and right end we will use for weaving. Now you can see that we have secured the ends with tape here, but now when we're weaving it, you need to pull it to make it tight. So if you want, you can put a lot more tape on this and fix it in place, or you can use a nail and hammer and just put a nail right in the middle of the clip. Now this will secure it further and it won't move. Okay, so for the weaving, you first take the left side or the left end and we will pass it through the middle two right here. It comes out, goes under like this, like that. Now we'll take the right side or the right end and we will pass it under the right end, over the middle two, and then under the left end, like this. And when you pull the ends, it looks like this. I'll show you one more time. So we'll take the left side, go under the middle two. So it's over the left one, under the middle two, and then over the right one. And now the right side, we go under, over, and under. Now pull the ends and tighten it like this, and then repeat the same process. Once you have reached about an inch and a half or two, you can put a D-ring. This will help you attach the main leash to the collar. So first, you go under, you take out the end right here, then you pass it through the D-ring. This way, you will get your D-ring somewhere in the middle, like this. Now we'll repeat the same process. Now the right one, under, through the D-ring, over the middle two, and under the left one, and then pull. Yep, I think with this fourth one, it's nice and secure. Look at that. And you can see we are pretty much done with our collar. Okay, so we have reached the end of the collar and now we need to lock this. So first, I'm going to take the right end and slip it down right here. Just like that, pull it tight. And we have to do the same thing for this left end. So you can see we have pulled out both the ends here. Now we'll just flip it, leaving a couple of inches. I can cut the extra cord. Now we make a knot here and then we will take the ends and try and squeeze them out through one of these loops. Okay, so we'll loop it one more time and then tie a knot so that we have these two little ends. And now we'll use a lighter and we'll just fuse them. Using a lighter, be careful. While it's still hot, I am squeezing the ends so that they fuse together. Push it under one of the loops so that it doesn't hurt our furry friend. With that, we are done. And we have a brand new collar. Check it out. And with that, we are done with our video. I think Shadow really loves this collar. What do you think? Shadow, woof, woof. What did you guys think? Do let me know in the comment section below. Hey, you're blocking my camera. Come here. Do let me know in the comment section below. And definitely like, share, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Look at these guys, yeah. They give us so much unconditional love. I think we should do something special for them this Mutts Day. If you have a pet, if you have a dog, then make something special for your dog. And if you don't have one, adopt one so that we can celebrate with these guys. Shadow, you wanna go out and play? Yeah, I think we're going to do that. So I'll see you next time. Until then, be good and do good. Peace. Come on, baby. Come on, yeah, balance. Good. Good job. One more. Woof. Say woof. No, woof. All right. Come, boy.